Okay, turn the sound on. Hello, everyone.
Hi, Dr. Nick.
Hi, Dr. Nick. What are you doing?
Cruelly forcing you to be cute.
Cruelly forcing me to be cute.
That hard bitch that I am.
Okay, we're not even going to use this for a while, because today we have the ice water here, which you can see. How about I turn off? What is the sound? I need to turn off the sound. No. Why am I hearing my own video? Do I have it in a different screen? Do I have it running? No. Why am I hearing my own video? Oh, the Pixel camera has sound. Don't need that. Why do I hear my own sound? This is the weirdest thing. Excuse me while I figure out what is going on here. Why is it playing my audio? I can actually solve this problem. Hopefully. Maybe. Oh. Sorry about the loud clicks, everyone.
This one? It is this one. That's what I get for watching my own video to make sure that it's working.
Okay.
Today we're gonna use our sourdough. Bubbly sourdough. Look at that. Ooh, nice and bubbly. And we're going to start making sourdough bread. Sourdough bread. This is a recipe I found online that doesn't need any yeast, except for the yeast that's in our bubbly sourdough. So, we're gonna try it out. The downside of this recipe is that it takes 4 hours on the first rice and 8 hours on the second rice. And I'm sorry about my camera being in the worst spot it possibly could be. But my other camera hasn't arrived yet, so you get bad laptop camera angle for now, at least. And hopefully things will be okay. But let's, number one, let's take a look at our recipe for this recipe needs, oops, let me look at this. It doesn't need anything. It has 3 ingredients. Can't see that at all. Salt, bread flour, sourdough starter. So I'm going to put the salt in. So 9 grams. Oops, you can't see the thing here, right? Let me move the sourdough out of the way. Can you see that? No. Make this work. Aha! It's upside down. But 9 grams salt, 425 grams bread flour. So no, I get to read it upside down. Four twenty-five, close enough. Grams of bread flour. We'll keep the bread flour around for fun. Whatever. And I'm just going to use a fork. We want to whisk these together. And then we're going to use 285 grams of sourdough starter. So, we'll do that. These basically mixed together so that they're all evenly matched or whatever. I'm gonna use a spoon to spoon out the sourdough starter because it's kind of gross otherwise. Sourdough starter to go into and tear out that so that we have a zero.
Yep.
Okay. And 285 grams, which is going to be lots of spoons worth. I'm going to get one of this one actually. It says it's about 10 ounces, so that's about half a cup. This is a quarter cup. So. Okay, so 285. I'm gonna leave that there for a sec. I'm gonna feed this sourdough starter because it got a little bit low. If you can see, yeah. So I'm gonna add more flour and some more water. I'm gonna add, I guess, probably a half cup of flour and a quarter cup of water. Out of there, move this out of the way, so I'm just going to feed this a little bit because I used up a lot of it, more than I thought I had a lot of it, but that was a lot putting in there. I can understand why this recipe doesn't have any water by default, because it gets a lot from in here.
little bit of water every time. Because this is really dry. Kind of expect it to be more wet. Oh, I might have added too much water. I could add some more salt. Now it got really wet. That's about as wet as I... More wet than I expected it to be. Only a little bit of water. But at least it's together now. And I'll put that bowl away. And I can start... kneading it on the table. Turn it into something. This is very strange in comparison to like most of the doughs that I make, in that it doesn't have any like butter or oil in this part. It's just flour and salt and sourdough starter, which is basically just flour and salt and yeast. Because the sourdough starter is just yeast and sourdough. And now it's coming into something more reasonable, I guess. I'm gonna do this for about 10 minutes. So I'm gonna turn on my 10 minute timer. Cause that's how long I need to knead this. It's kind of hard to knead. But let me turn on my timer here. Oop. And start it. Oop. Okay. Continually drying out, which is like the opposite of what most of my things do. Hi.
I have you on about 30 seconds delay.
Oh, okay. Is that how much the delay is?
It's probably more like about 20.
Now you have your cell phone. Not much delay.
Uh-huh.
Wait. Really weird that this is like drying out as I knead it. We have about 8.5 minutes left. I might just make my hands a little bit wet. But it's coming out very, very dry. And I guess I don't care that much if it, as long as it doesn't break apart.
It would really suck if it turned out we suddenly had too much bread.
Oh no.
You know why?
Why?
Because then that bread would go unneeded.
Oh gosh. I'm doomed. Y'all are doomed too, by the way. Get my workout for the day by kneading. Add some water. I just add some water to my hands a little bit, and that'll get worked into the dough. Might need just kneading it. And I might do that a couple more times. Maybe I'll steal from some of my cold water here. But I do actually kind of want it to be warm. We have our cold water for the other half of this prep, which is more dough making, but not bread dough. I'm gonna make some apple pie dough, but not like a normal amount of apple pie dough. It's like, found a recipe from
New York Times that I want to try out. It uses golden delicious apples, which is really weird, but we have a mandolin here, so I thought I would make something that uses it. Thank you. But dough it is, surprisingly. No. No needing jokes from me, you know me. I would play music, but YouTube would probably ban me. Playing music.
Banned
because of the band.
Banned. It's like the Flintstones. Banned.
Oh gosh. Okay, this is getting pretty dry again, so. Let's add a couple of handfuls of water. How much it reacts to that. It's all slippery and slimy now. Not gonna work it in there. Building up the gluten in this is really difficult because there's only flour. That's all I'm needing is really. So building up gluten in flour. The good news is I get to use the food processor for the other half of this. So ten minutes. Oh gosh, we still have 4 minutes left.
Well, you got your exercise for the day.
Yeah, it's all about, this is what happens, is I'm like, oh, I must be mostly done by now. I've been kneading forever. But no, I still have like half of it left.
Gosh, Marie, you're so needy.
No, yes, that's right. Such a needy, needy, needy girl. Oh gosh.
Coda thinks I should play What You Need by NXS. I agree.
I am needing. I don't need that.
Love, can you help me out?
Can you coat that big bowl there? Well, clean it out first, but coat that big bowl there with olive oil. That's where we're gonna put this in. And then we're done. And I won't subject y'all to 4 hours of
rising. I think you should just leave the camera trained on.
Leave
anybody
that camera.
Wants to tune in and watch it rise?
Sure. It'll be a little bit less than 4 hours of rising, I guess, because I'm going to be making the other stuff here. This is really turning into like kind of a silky dough. I can definitely tell the difference between what it was before and now. I might still need to add a little bit more water because it's foldy and not like one lump. You can see, I wonder if I can show you all.
Well, I mean, this is the week that Kenny
it's
Rogers
like,
died, right? We don't know how to fold him.
No, mm-hmm. The worst. Did Kenny Rogers really die this week?
Yep.
Oh, that makes me sad.
As well should.
I hope it wasn't.
It was not.
Okay, he wasn't getting up there.
Oh, good. Only 2 minutes left. I can do anything for 100 seconds, or at least that's what I tell myself when I'm exercising. I do actually hope this comes out. It's very different than all the other bread that I make. I will punch it down and knead it again just before we go to bed, I guess. Probably won't stream the final bake, but I'll post pictures of pictures on my. I'm gonna post pictures on my Twitter, and y'all can see it.
Why aren't you gonna stream the final bake, Marie?
Because I'm gonna post pictures on my Twitter.
That's not a good reason. You can post pictures and stream the final bake.
No, I can't.
Why not?
Well, because it's complex. I have complex reasons. Stop that. Okay, so there we have it. That's the dough. Let's see if I can get this into camera frame here. That's how it looks. It's maybe a little bit dry, but it's stretchy. See how if I do this, it doesn't break. That's kind of great. I'm gonna pinch the back end here, make it into a little ball, like so. It's got a lot of gluten in it because you can see it stretching out on the top here instead of breaking, which is what it would do if it didn't have gluten in it. So now I'm going to take this, which my lovely assistant Daria has coated with some olive oil.
Your ugly assistant Daria?
Lovely assistant Daria.
Okay.
And we flip it one side, flip it the other side. Look at that lovely ball of dough. Put it in there, and then we start the timer here. This one's on my phone because I'm turning off the stream. 4 hours. Let's go. And let me get a tea towel. It says actually for this to rise in a cool place. Our place is not very cool. Actually, the place is very, very cool, like, but it's not, it's cold. So, I'm going to put this aside, I'm going to put it over here, and we'll leave it there until it's done. And I'm going to clean up my space a little bit, and then gather ingredients for our pie, and also wash my hands. Well, that's cool. Leftover gluten that just kind of inhabited our workspace here. We don't really need it for this. Also, we can scrape off what's left of that sourdough starter that we dropped. Sorry if this noise is not great.
Recipe.
Okay. I'm going to stare at y'all for a little bit while I go look at my recipe. Let's see. Where did I put it? Is this camera set up okay this time? I'm going left, and it's left, and I'm going right, and it's right. I can flip it if it needs to be flipped. I don't think it does, though. Maybe? I don't know. It's in a different place than it was last time. Let's see if I can find this recipe. Here it is. Let me download that. And then open it up. Okay. For the dough. Bread flour. We need bread flour, whole wheat flour, sugar, sea salt, cold butter, 2 sticks of butter, ice water, which I have here. Put that there. And apple cider vinegar, 1 tablespoon. 1 tablespoon.
Let's get the apple cider vinegar first. I forgot to ask the vinegar. Should be right.
Oh, here, you have a fine bottle, right?
Nope, here.
No, here we are.
There's more up there.
Okay.
But like, the size that is easy to use is right there.
1 tablespoon. Okay. Flour, sugar. Sugar is here. We need 40 grams of whole wheat flour, which is going to be up here. In our special flour section, wheat flour. Wheat flour from Anson Mills. There, and we need salt, which we have, and cold butter, which I'll get out later and cut it into chunks. Okay, so I need 120 milliliters of water, but I'll measure that later, and we are going to use this beast for this recipe. It later, but let's do some measuring, shall we? I'll measure all of this into a bowl that is big enough for us to have the stuff, but small enough that you guys can all still see stuff. And 340 grams of bread flour. Of whole wheat flour, which is not a lot compared to the regular wheat flour. Flour, whole wheat flour, sugar, and salt all go into the food processor at once. So 40 grams whole wheat flour.
Food processing.
the flour and the butter, and making a dough. Teaspoons granulated sugar. Teaspoons. Four and a half teaspoons is 1 tablespoon plus 1 teaspoon plus 1/2 teaspoon. One teaspoon fine sea salt. The sea salt is fine. And let's see what else. Okay, the salt and the sugar and the flour, all that goes into the food processor. Need to cut this butter. I like keeping butter when it's cold like this. Do it this way. It just needs to be in small enough chunks that it'll get like subsumed by the processor. So I'm not trying to be too exact here. Drop in the chunks of butter. Yeah, okay. I'm actually just going to take the sauce so I can drop these in. Done with the sugar.
much butter. All the butter is on. Okay. And then 8 to 10 long pulses. Let's go. I'm going to turn off the mic for this because it's loud. Okay, one more. Now, finally, we're going to put our water and vinegar in, and we're going to put it in as we pulse it. I need to measure my water. It's ice water, and I should have too much of it. But let me measure it anyway. I should have 120 milliliters ice water, which means 120 grams. And then our teaspoon of vinegar, like so. That's done. Turn the oil more. Turn it off. Okay. And then this goes like this. And then the liquid over the dough as you pulse the machine, forming a most moist dough. Doughy that is. It's really doughy. Scrape this out of here. Right there. If I can get this out, that'd be great. Oh, excellent. Okay. How moist that is. That's nice. It's really very nice and well mixed. Very buttery, I can tell. Let me scrape the rest of this out of here. There we go. Put that back there for now. And that's pretty much it. Work it, scrape it on the work surface, shape it into a log, and now we're going to chill this. That's pretty much it. That's the pie dough. I'm shaping it into a kind of a thing that's easy to go into thirds, like so. We can use our cutter. That looks like about thirds to me, maybe a little bit more over here, and a little more over here.
One of those is going to be smaller. Each piece into a disc like so, and then I'm going to go get my saran wrap and we're done. Except for the cleaning, which we used a food processor, so it's of course going to be much more difficult to clean. So all of this is going to go into the fridge, all three of those, and then we're just going to wait around and stuff. Butter, butter, butter. That's very buttery. It's going to cool down so that that butter all solidifies, and well, tomorrow these will be made into pie crusts. Now just the cleaning. All right, that's all for now. See you tomorrow, maybe? I don't know.